Georgia versus Jamie L. Hood. Count one, malice murder of Elmer Buddy Christian. We, the jury, find the defendant guilty. Count two, felony murder of Elmer Buddy Christian. We, the jury, find the defendant guilty. Count three, felony murder of Elmer Buddy Christian.
And the counts, they continued, folks. We're following breaking news out of Athens tonight. After just one day of deliberations, the jury has convicted Jamie Hood of malice murder in the death of Officer Buddy Christian. Hood was also found guilty of attempted murder of Officer Tony Howard. He was found not guilty on charges involving his alleged hostages, who Hood maintained were his friends. And our Duffy Dixon was in court for the verdict. She is working right now to get more reaction for us for tonight. From here, there is a second phase, however, of the trial, one in which the jury is now set to decide between a life or death sentence. And joining me now to discuss the verdict and what's next for Jamie Hood is criminal defense attorney Jill Polster. Thanks a lot for being with us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
You walked in right on time as the story was breaking. We're talking about 70 counts. That is a lot, and it is rare, or is it rare, I should say, for a jury to come back so quickly with all of those counts. And what's next?
They were only out for 4 hours on 70 counts, and that is lightning fast. I think it's because they're sequestered. I think they were motivated to get a verdict. And so what's next is they'll remain sequestered for the penalty phase, which I think will start in the morning.
And it was interesting just to watch Hood represent himself. Of course, he was very animated throughout the trial. Are there grounds for appeal because he did, in fact, represent himself?
No. The court is required to give him admonitions related to that before he takes upon his own representation. He actually waives the ability to raise ineffective assistance of counsel, which he would have been able to raise had he been represented by an attorney.
And does it ever work in your favor to represent yourself?
Oh, yes. Yes, it does.
Why so?
I think that defendants who represent themselves, you'll see the court and the prosecution trying to make the trial go smoothly and in some cases sort of helping them along. I think the jury gets more exposure to the defendant and get to see him. It humanizes them more.
But at some point he had trouble understanding some of the sort of like proceedings that go on without the trial or throughout the trial. Do you think that hurt his credibility, or from the very beginning the jury was like, wait, no way?
I think the jury will discount those mistakes. They know he's not an attorney.
So what can we expect in the sentencing phase? I know we're talking about life or death.
Right.
Now.
I think you'll hear from a lot of victims and victim family members. There were 15 named victims, and I think they will be brought into court to give victim impact statements on behalf of Mr. Hood. They're required to present evidence in mitigation about his family history, his education, any mental health issues or special education growing up, anything that might have affected him up to this point.
And is he allowed to speak to defend himself in the second phase, or is this the last that we will hear from Jamie Hood?
I am not sure. He has standby counsel, and I think he could be represented by his other attorneys during the penalty phase if he wanted to.
And how long could this phase last? Will it sort of be similar to the first trial? Because it did last a long time.
It did. I don't think it will last as long as the trial. That was 19 days of testimony. I think it will take some time because of the number of victims, but it should not take that long.
Right. That's why you are the expert, and we're so glad you walked in just in time. Yes. Jill Polster, always good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All right.